Ukraine just deployed one of the most exciting and innovative pieces of military technology the world has ever seen, and it's making Russia's aerial forces absolutely useless. It's called the Sky Sentinel, an AI-powered machine gun turret with the intelligence and the firepower to bring down Russian drones and missiles with ease. Here's a closer look at what it is, how it was made, and what it's capable of. At first glance, the Sky Sentinel might not look at all that groundbreaking or impressive. It's made up of a .50 caliber M2 Browning machine gun mounted on a rotary turret that can spin a full 360 degrees and fire on targets all around it. That's nothing new. Turrets like this have been used in warfare for decades, with human operators adjusting the gun's direction and elevation and choosing the right time to fire. But the Sky Sentinel doesn't need any human operator. It's powered entirely by artificial intelligence, with zero manual intervention required. The AI handles everything, from identifying targets to adjusting aim and firing. Ukrainian soldiers, meanwhile, only have to worry about placing the turret in position and firing it up. Then they can simply sit back and watch the magic happen. The intelligence powering the Sky Sentinel was created entirely in Ukraine, and the developers faced numerous challenges during its creation. They had to ensure, for example, that the Sky Sentinel could accurately spot viable targets. It needs to be able to tell drones and missiles apart from birds, for instance. It also has to be able to lock onto its targets instantly, as well as working out how fast they're traveling, which direction they're going, and even take other factors like wind resistance into account in order to calculate the perfect direction, angle, and moment to fire its rounds. And it has to do all of that in fractions of seconds. There's no time for hesitation or delay when dealing with Russia's intense aerial attacks, when military and civilian lives are on the line. On top of all that, the turret itself has to be flawless from a mechanical perspective in order to work seamlessly with the AI and successfully strike its target. Speaking with United 24 Media, members of the Sky Sentinel development team explained some of the difficulties they faced. One of the biggest engineering hurdles for this kind of weapon is something called play mechanical slack. In simple terms, this refers to the fact that even the tiniest of mechanical movements can lead to targeting errors. If the turret's aim is a single millimeter out of line, it may completely fail to hit its target, wasting round after round in the process. Even with a state-of-the-art AI brain and high-end radar system to help it spot and lock onto targets, the turret has to be mechanically sound or everything falls apart. And it's important to remember that this is a rapidly moving machine. A turret can spin a full 360 degrees, as well as being able to raise and lower its machine gun. Plus, it's often going to be on the move, transported here and there on the backs of trucks and mobile platforms. With all that movement and numerous complicated components, it's easy to imagine how one little piece could fall ever so slightly out of alignment. That's why the Sky Sentinel engineers had to ensure every aspect of this turret's design and construction was just right. As one of the engineers explained, "We had to build a system that moves a lot with zero mechanical play, and not just moves but fires, which means it also has to handle recoil." The lead engineer added, "We're solving dozens of micro challenges so that everything works as a single seamless system. No mechanical slack, no software delays, flawless optics, and precision firing. It all has to work in perfect sync." Naturally, it took plenty of time and hard work to achieve that, and all of the mechanics of the Sky Sentinel were pieced together and tested entirely in Ukraine, out on the training grounds, and even in real combat scenarios. Ukraine has also had to source key components, like high-resolution sensors, day-night cameras, multi-spectral optic systems, and precision lasers from various countries around the world, since it doesn't have the means to make them itself. These targeting and range-finding components essentially serve as the AI's eyes and ears. They provide a clear, complete, and uninterrupted view of the sky and surrounding environment, allowing the AI to spot, identify, and commence fire on its targets in an instant with unmatched accuracy. As soon as a target crosses the range threshold, the AI essentially springs into life, carrying out countless complex mathematical calculations instantaneously and continuously to understand the target's flight path and aim in just the right places. It takes dozens of factors into account in the blink of an eye, like wind drift, turret vibration, and rotor wash, resulting in targeting so precise that every single round fired has a strong chance of striking its target. It's almost like the turret is firing guided rounds, except it's not. It uses standard .50 caliber ammunition, which is cheap, simple, and plentiful. And affordability is one of the biggest benefits the Sky Sentinel brings to the table. Each unit costs just $150,000 to make. That's remarkably cheap when comparing it to air defense systems like the German Iris-T SLM, which cost around $185 million per system, or the US Patriot, which costs approximately $1.1 billion. Of course, the Sky Sentinel isn't anywhere near as complex or powerful as either of those systems, but it's still a very impressive and capable air defense weapon, more than ready to bring down many of the aerial threats that Russia can send Ukraine's way. It can easily wipe out the likes of Shahed drones, for example, which can cost around $50,000 each, and it's much more cost-effective to use a $150,000 turret to take out swarms of drones than to fire dozens of expensive interceptor missiles instead. This is essentially important right now, at a time when Ukraine has to be economic with its resources and is facing some of the largest and most intense aerial attacks since the war began. Only days ago, the country had to contend with the biggest missile and drone strike of the conflict, with Russia launching in excess of 500 drones and around a dozen missiles at the Ukrainian capital of Kyiv, killing one person and wounding 23 others. And this is just one of a growing number of attacks. The stats show that Russia has ramped up its drone strikes in June and July by around 500% compared to prior months, with Fred Kagan, a senior fellow at the American Enterprise Institute, stating, "The Ukrainians are getting pounded at an unprecedented level of intensity. They need air defense of all sorts urgently." Ukraine hasn't always been able to rely on allies around the world to supply the systems and missiles it needs, but is proving more than capable of creating powerful and cost-effective alternatives of its own, like the Sky Sentinel. United 24 estimates that around 10 to 30 of these turrets would be needed to guard a single city. That's around $1.5 to $4.5 million worth of hardware, which is still remarkably cheap compared to the huge price tags attached to more complicated air defense units. Plus, as mentioned earlier on, since these systems use perfectly normal, cheap ammunition rather than costly smart rounds or expensive missiles, there's no need to worry about heavy operating costs. It's even relatively energy efficient, so won't put any excessive strain on local power grids as and when it's deployed. As well as being an affordable means of air defense, the Sky Sentinel is also a highly mobile option. Mounted on a trailer, it can be easily moved around wherever it's needed, repositioned and redeployed in key strategic locations across Ukraine, whether they be along the front lines or deeper in the country's territory. This too is a huge advantage, as it allows Ukraine to rapidly adapt to the changing conditions of the conflict, setting up its intelligent automated turrets wherever it feels they're needed. And once they're in place, these turrets really pack a punch. Not just theoretical firepower either. The Sky Sentinel has already proven itself in real-world combat scenarios, as confirmed by Yuri, a commander of Ukraine's air defense group, in an interview with Business Insider. He stated that the turret had already been deployed in real combat, demonstrating high effectiveness. And while the Ukrainian armed forces aren't willing to divulge too many details about how and where the prototype has been used, Yuri claimed that it successfully took out no less than 6 Russian Shahed drones. With an average of 100 of those drones flying over the border daily, Ukraine needs all the help it can get to target and take them out. The Sky Sentinel is more than capable of that. It even earned the nickname Shahed Catcher among Ukrainian troops due to its incredible effectiveness. Plus, thanks to its speed and efficiency, it's also able to take out smaller targets. In fact, United 24 media claims it can strike targets 5 times smaller than Shahed's, so even if Russia deploys mini covert drones in attempt to bypass the turrets, the Sky Sentinel should have no trouble spotting them and bringing them down. Additionally, the M2 Browning machine gun sitting atop the Sky Sentinel has a kill radius of around 1.5 kilometers, or just under a mile. So any drones that come within that range are either going to explode in midair or be sent plummeting to the ground in no time. And it's not only drones that the Sky Sentinel can handle. As Yuri notes, this is a cost-effective and scalable solution for defending both cities and frontline regions from Shahed's, reconnaissance drones, and even cruise missiles. That's right, even cruise missiles are viable targets for this sci-fi style AI turret. Able to rotate at a rate of 150 meters per second, the Sky Sentinel can strike targets traveling at speeds of up to 500 miles per hour. That includes the likes of Russia's Caliber and KH-101 cruise missiles. Before the Sky Sentinel, machine gun turrets simply had no chance of taking out those kinds of missiles, as human operators weren't able to respond fast enough and adjust their aim accordingly to fire on them. The Sky Sentinel AI, however, is more than fast enough. And that poses a huge new challenge to Russia, as Ukraine's air defenses continue to improve with the Sky Sentinel turrets and other innovative solutions supplied by the country's partners. Russia's aerial bombardments will become less effective and more wasteful. Countless more drones will fall harmlessly from the sky, costly missiles will fail to strike their targets, and Russia's resources will continue to dwindle. The Kremlin will have to react accordingly, but has already shifted its military strategy so much to focus on aerial warfare and drone swarms in particular. If those swarms stop getting results, Russia may find that its territorial gains, which are already progressing at a snail's pace, become even slower, and its losses will keep on mounting up. Let's not forget that the country hit the grim milestone of 1 million casualties last month and is on track to lose countless more troops and pieces of equipment for long as the war continues. As well as being tough enough to take out missiles and various types of drones, the Sky Sentinel also has the remarkable advantage of being ready to use right away without the need for any kind of operator training programs. That's the power of AI. Traditionally, whenever a military force develops a new weapon, vehicle, or defensive system, it takes time to actually use it in real-world settings, as people have to be trained in how to use it. And if the operators are injured or killed in combat, the system effectively becomes useless until another human operator or entire operating team comes along. With AI-powered weaponry, like the Sky Sentinel, those issues simply don't exist. As stated earlier, all the soldiers really have to do is make sure the turret has a power supply. As long as it's powered up, it doesn't require any additional human intervention or control. The AI, combined with the built-in sensors and scanners, does all the work. It scans the skies, locks onto targets in an instant, and fires with ruthless precision. Thanks to that, Ukraine could theoretically make and deploy dozens, if not hundreds, of these turrets along the front lines or around major towns and cities and enjoy instant protection in those areas. In a war where even the tiniest delay or disruption can cost lives, that kind of instantaneous effectiveness is invaluable. Perhaps even more exciting is the fact that the Sky Sentinel has been crafted with a modular design, which opens the door to potential upgrades and variants in the future. Indeed, the developers are said to already be looking into other ways to equip these AI turrets for more specialized missions and roles, and there are so many possibilities to consider. Ukraine might, for example, need turrets that can see further and spot targets faster than the standard model. In that case, all it has to do is swap out the sensor array. Or it might want to upgrade its AI to respond and fire even more rapidly. If so, it can simply install a more sophisticated processing module. Future variants of the Sky Sentinel could even be equipped with different caliber machine guns or multi-barrel weaponry, packing even more firepower to deal even more damage to Russian targets. And because of the modular design, these kinds of upgrades won't take long at all to implement. In fact, it might take mere days or weeks for new variants to emerge, with one component simply and conveniently swapped out for another. Ukraine could even, theoretically, find ways to mount Sky Sentinels on mobile turrets or unify them across a mesh network, with a single centralized command system, perfect for defending larger and important locations like big cities or contested sections of the front lines. Of course, like any other piece of military hardware, the Sky Sentinel isn't perfect. It has its flaws and presents challenges that Ukraine's armed forces will need to acknowledge and overcome. For one thing, despite its remarkable speed, pinpoint accuracy, and efficiency, a machine gun turret is never going to be at the same level of strength as a more elaborate missile-based air defense system like the Patriot. While the Sky Sentinel can clearly take out drones and even some missiles, certain types of targets like larger missiles, fighter jets, and other aircraft are likely to be beyond its reach. But that doesn't necessarily matter all that much, since the Sky Sentinel wasn't created for those kind of targets. It's a drone killer, plain and simple, with the added advantage of also being able to bring down missiles. It's designed to be just one piece in a larger air defense machine, working alongside other systems and easing the burden on the likes of the Patriot and the Iris-T SLM, giving Ukraine another layer of defense, another option to turn to when it might not need or want to waste expensive interceptor missiles on relatively low-value targets like Shahed's. The other more problematic challenge that Ukraine needs to address is scalability. Making and perfecting a prototype is one thing, but the Sky Sentinel team now needs to find a way to mass produce this system, churning out dozens of units, all to the same exceptionally high standards of mechanical precision. They have to be flawless and identical, as even a minor flaw could throw the system off and render the AI far less effective. Fortunately, this is something that developers are already working on, with the objective of delivering dozens of turrets on a monthly basis, and they're confident of success. Speaking again to United 24 Media, the lead developer admitted that mass production is a challenge, but it's absolutely doable. Ukraine is a vast country, and Russia's attacks are not merely limited to the front lines. It regularly targets towns and cities far and wide with its missiles and drones. As such, Ukraine faces a huge logistical challenge in terms of defending its entire territory from the invaders. And even if mass production is achieved, it would take a long time to manufacture and deploy Sky Sentinels everywhere they're needed. As such, Ukraine will need to be resourceful with these turrets, as it has been with various other air defense systems, artillery, and other key pieces of military hardware. It will likely want to prioritize important and valuable locations, like power facilities, bases, and command posts, as well as towns and cities that are facing regular and repeat bombardments, such as Kyiv or Kharkiv. Over time, as more turrets arrive, more places will be able to enjoy their protection, and this may very well prove to be a tide-turning addition to the Ukrainian arsenal, a colossal counterbalance to the persistent aerial threat of Russia. In the broader scheme of things, this turret is also another astonishing example of everything that Ukraine has demonstrated over the course of the war so far – resilience, ingenuity, and resourcefulness. In the face of insurmountable odds, facing an enemy that is ruthless and overwhelming in its approach, Ukraine has repeatedly had to dig deep and find whatever ways it can to defend itself. And while it has had enormous support from allies across Europe and North America, it also had to look inward, coming up with its own ideas and developing its own weapons and defensive systems to withstand Russia's aggression. Ukraine has demonstrated many examples of astonishing innovation, and the Sky Sentinel is one of the best yet. Efficient, effective, innovative, and economical too, this AI-powered turret has it all, and with more investment and development, there's no telling what a valuable addition it may prove to be. Now, learn about another of Ukraine's newest drone-busting additions in our video about the Shark anti-drone aircraft. Or check out our recent deep dive look at the 16 Russian generals Ukraine has taken out since the war started. And finally, make sure to subscribe to our channel also for more regular, reliable, and informative updates from the front lines of the conflict.